Hey everyone, I am here today with a special requested video. I was requested, I believe from Candace, to do a video on my fall/Halloween coloring books that I'd like to work out of this season. So I did this, I think, for Christmas last year. I don't know if I did it for fall, but I'm gonna do it this year since it was a special request. So let's get started. So this is one of the first books and I'm already working in it. I'll show you what I'm working on. I haven't done anything else in this book yet, but this is Seasons by Hannah Carlson. This has all of the seasons, winter, spring, summer, fall. It's got some holidays in it with bunny rabbits and Santa Claus and stuff. But this is what I'm working on for the fall season. This is the first picture that I've started in this book, and I'm so far really enjoying working on it. As you know with me, it will be stickly and lovely, but this is as far as I've gotten. I just started this morning. There's a lot of cute pictures in here, and one, like, here's a Christmas one, so I will also supplement this for Christmas time because I do want to work on the Christmas pictures in here. But we also have, like, ones like this, and I didn't even realize this was in here until today. So there's some really cute pictures in here for all the different seasons. Here's a hot bunny one. Then there's just some regular ones, but there are some really nice ones for the fall season. And you know something, the truth of it is, like, you could make any picture you want. So this one really isn't designated for anything, right? But you could make this fall colors and make it yourself whatever you want it to be. So if you wanted to take some extra pages that really aren't designated, you wouldn't say to any season, just make them your own colors and do them dedicated to that season. That's what I do. So I'm really looking forward to working in this book. This is the first one of her books that I'm just, like, really excited to work in because they have some really great pictures for the seasons. And I like a lot of the pictures in this one. So this is what I'm working on now, and I will probably finish this either tonight or tomorrow. The next book is this one. It's The Beauty of Horror 2. I also have The Beauty of Horror 1, but this one is a new one coming out for this year. It's coming out September 19th. I showed this in a flip through. I'm not sure if that's up yet, but I already did one picture in this because I like to actually work in the books before I can review them. I feel like you can't really review something unless you've tried it and used it. So I worked on Giuliana here, where she's eating an ice cream, and I had a lot of fun working on this one. I used my super colors on this, so you guys may remember a long time ago when I hit 3,000 subscribers, Frank took me out to buy a set of pencils, and I bought the 80 count of the Caran d'Ache super colors. Now, the super colors are watercolor pencils, but you can also use them for regular pencils. So that is what I did here. I did not use any water on this. This is just regular pencils. And as you can see, they came out really nice. And after using them on this, I can honestly say they're my second favorite pencil after my Polychromos. I have the 80 count. I'm going to be getting the 120 count very, very soon because I absolutely love those pencils. Plus, I can buy them open stock at Dick Blick. So super excited about that and that find because I've used them several. Okay, I'm just going on and on about these pencils. I love them. That's enough. Anyway, so that's what I used on here. I did put some stickles on the sprinkles on her ice cream because, you know, it's me, stickles, yes. And I used pastels, chalk pastels for the background. So I really enjoyed working in this book. I had no problems at all with the pencils. They went on like a dream. It's beautiful paper. You can definitely use some watercolors in this. And if you like horror books, this is one for you. And the first one is just as really, really, you know, cute. And I said this in my flip through video, and I'm gonna say it here too for those that may not have watched the flip through of it. If you are not into horror but you kind of like the book, you can make it silly like I did. You can make it with pastel colors and stuff. It doesn't have to be gory. So I'm going to really look forward to working more in this book. Okay, the next one I have for you is The Nightmare Before Christmas, and I've shown you guys this. I've done a flip through of it. I'm going to use this for both Christmas and Halloween because you can use it for both, but I'm probably going to primarily use it for the Halloween season. There's a few pictures I definitely want to do with some pumpkins and stuff in it, but I've shown you guys this before, so I'm not going to do like a full flip through, just a few pages here and there. And I really, really like this book, and I'm going to stickle the heck out of this book. Okay, the next book is this one. This is Molly Harrison's fantasy and fairy tale coloring book. I've shown this one to you guys before, and I had forgotten about it, and then I was thinking today when I was going through my books to say, like, what I want to use and stuff, and then I remembered. This has some witches. Oh, I did do a picture in this one. I did this all with markers. I'm not so hot with markers, but I like using them on the Create Space paper. It just makes it easier for me. I haven't finished her eye. I need to, like, kind of work on that, but yeah. So this was my test page to see how I could do with the markers. And it has some really cute, like, Halloween witchy type pictures in here. Not all of them, but, like, this one. And then you have some ones with, like, pumpkins. And I'm going to do a couple in here. It's going to be, like, my marker book because I'm not so good with the markers. I'm not, like, a huge fan of them. Here's another Halloween one. But I'd like to get better at them and see if I can do anything fun with them. We'll see. I'm not running out and buying any markers. I have some Sharpies. I have some Prismacolor ones that I got for Christmas last year. And I have some Crayola Super Tips. So I have enough to do with what I want to do with it. But there's only a few Halloween pictures in here. But, I mean, I would designate that one as a Halloween picture. And the few witches that I showed you, like this one for sure, is a Halloween one. So I'm going to work in this one with my markers when I'm not, you know, into coloring with my pencils for the night or whatever, and just see what I can do with that one. Okay, the next one is the one that we're going to be using for our color along. You've probably seen my video on this already. First of all, I have to stop for a second and just let you know that you probably hear the crickets outside. They're probably really loud, I know, but they like to hang out outside my window when I'm filming, so I hope that they give you a nice ambiance, at least for the background. Everyone tells me it's nice and relaxing, so I hope you like that. You can also hear some of the cicadas, so I apologize. I hope that's okay. Anywho, back to the book. This is what we're going to be using for our color along. It is Shalene's color along. She is hosting it. She has asked, I think, five of us, or is it five of us? It's Shalene, myself, Anne Hatfield, Anne Siggers, and Jessica Robertson. Yes, okay, so it's five of us that are working on this. We're going to be announcing the pictures very soon, but I have done one picture in here last year. I will show you. This was when I first started coloring, and I did it with pencils and markers. Not so great, but not so bad for somebody that just started out. I did this almost a year ago. It's October 25th of last year. This was my first Jasmine Beckett Griffith picture, and I'm proud of her for, you know, what she is and as I was learning. Like I said, she's not great, but as I was learning, it, you know, not bad. It was an idea of how to do it, and hopefully this year, as we'll be going on and coloring the different pictures, I can improve upon that and do some different stuff. So I'm looking forward to giving it another crack and seeing how I've improved within the year, and I definitely obviously have this on my list for this year. Okay, another one that I have from last year, and this is going to be like fall and November stuff because it does have some like November, autumn type things in it, like Thanksgiving. I would like to color these and do these with markers. They're little place cards for Thanksgiving, so I'd like to do that. I don't know if I've actually done anything in this book before, but there are some really cute little pictures in here. I believe I got this in the supermarket last year. So yeah, see, it says autumn 2016. So yeah, I do believe I got this in the supermarket. There's a lot of repeating patterns in here that I won't do, but every now and again you find a cute little picture to do. So obviously I'm not going to work my way through all of these books in every picture, but I can work on some of them. And like I said, some of them are really super cute. I'm not sure. They are single-sided, so I might just do markers or watercolors. We'll see. It's not the thickest of paper, but I think I could definitely do something in these. So we shall see. Like I said, there's a lot of Thanksgiving in here, so maybe I'll save this one for closer to Thanksgiving. Okay, another one that I have that I got last year is Harvest Home. I think you can get this on Amazon. I got this, I think I might have got this at Barnes & Noble, I'm not sure. And I don't even know if I did anything in it. Oh, I did. I did this on I did this on October 26th. I did this with markers. As I mentioned to you guys, I did a lot of marker work when I first started out coloring. So I've come a long way from my marker days. of just really no shading or anything like that, just really going in with markers and coloring them. So this was one of my very first shading experiences with pencils. I did use pencils and markers on this one. And this is just a really cute little book, just some different pictures to do if you're looking for something for the autumn, Thanksgiving, Halloween season. So whatever I get done in these books, I get done great. And if I don't do anything, I don't know. But this is what I have for my collection. Okay, the next one is one that I've had for a year now. The artist, Carla Magana. I always pronounce her name wrong, but she forgives me. She sent me a copy of this when I first started coloring, and she sent me this to review, and she was one of the very first people that took a leap of faith in me and asked me to show her book, and this was her brand new book. So, Carla, thanks so much. You always have a special place in my heart for doing that. So I was working on this picture. I don't think I actually ever finished it. I need to finish it, but I was working on this for her color along, and I don't know, something happened that weekend. Maybe I wasn't feeling good or whatever, but this was her first color along that she did that I worked on, and I love this book. It's super cute, as you can see. It's got a really cute Halloween gothic type vibe in it. That picture with the skull was one of the very first pictures I ever did with my Prismacolors. This I did on January 1st. I remember working on this New Year's Eve into New Year's Day. This probably wouldn't take me as long as it took me that time, but like I said, I was a noob and I was just getting started. So I've had a lot of fun working in this book, and I intend on working on it some more through the Halloween season. Okay, the next book is one that I've gotten a while ago. I don't know if I actually showed it to you guys. I don't think I did. This is the Volume 1 Extended Edition of Nikki Burnett's Halloween Type Girls. I got it for that reason, that it's like Halloween Type Girls. It's not the grayscale one. It's her regular book. And just to show you, more than half of it has all this different kind of stuff where you can draw your own stuff, and it's got scales and stuff. So I want to put that out there. She gives you ideas of how to do different things with your colorings. And then it has some smaller pictures to color in it, like that. I guess if you wanted to make cards out of them or something, you could. And then from here forward, those are the minis. And then from here forward, you have your regular images. So this is thick Create Space paper. It's, you know, it is what it is, but you can still make some beautiful pictures in it. And I have seen my friend V, I think actually Anne from A Color for Life did this, maybe with grayscale with her markers. I think this might have been one of the first video I've ever seen of hers. But this isn't grayscale. This is just the regular line art. And I love this one. I love, love, love this one. Do you see? Let me bring it up closer. Do you see the candy corns on her hat and her dress? Oh my God, it's so cute. I think my friend V, Verily, did one of these. And I saw it and I said, okay, I think I want to try it because I liked hers so much. It might have been that one. Not 100% sure. But there's really cute pictures in here. So we'll see what I can do with this for the Halloween season. If it becomes a problem with, you know, coloring with pencils, I'll just do it with markers and call it a day. But I thought the pictures were really cute, especially that one with the candy corn. Okay, the next one is one that I received as a gift for my birthday. This is the Precious Pugs coloring book. And this book is one, again, that I'm going to use for all the different seasons. It has a lot of different holiday pictures in it. Like, I'll show you one of the very first ones in the beginning. It's like so stinking freaking cute. Look at this. I can't even take it. But we're not working on Easter yet. But this does have a really cute Halloween one in here, so I just wanted to show you guys. I'm going to be definitely working on this one because, you know, pug, Halloween, got to do it. There's like a fly on my page here. Okay, so isn't that super cute? So I'm going to be working on that picture from that book. And then I have another one for you. This is a splash of color. I got this last year. This is, you could find it like in the bookstores or at the supermarket. Now, I want to show you guys something that I was looking through this book the other day and I smiled to myself because this was the very first like Halloween book I ever bought to color, like when I started coloring. I only used my markers. I might have had a small set of Statler pencils. I did. So I was testing them out here, as you can see. And I just want to show you, these are my colored pictures. This is what I did October 8th. This is when I really started coloring. So I want you to see just, I know you guys comment a lot that you like my coloring and stuff, but I just want you to see how far I've come in a year. I've come a pretty far way from where I started. Now, I'm not embarrassed of these pictures. I think that they are a good reminder of when you start something and how much you learn when you don't even realize you're learning it. So just from watching the people in the community, I mean, there's so many people to mention that I've learned from, but you know, it really makes you feel good when you look at stuff like this and you say, wow, I've come a really long way from my first colorings. And it just really, I don't know what to say. I wouldn't want to say I'm proud of myself or anything like that, but I am kind of proud that I have taken in what I've seen and tried to improve upon it and learn more and do more. And I am looking forward to working in this book this year. And I'm going to mark, of course, like I did the dates. And this way, when I look back, obviously I'm not going to do all the pages, but when I look back on them next year, maybe I'll see even more improvement from this year to next year. So this is going to be kind of like my little book through the years to see where I've gone and what I've learned. And that's super exciting for me because I really like learning things and seeing what I can do. And I think this book is going to be a great reminder of that throughout the years. Okay, the next book is one of my favorites. I think this might be the first Hannah Lynn book that I ever bought, and I worked on this. I'll show you some of the things. Again, these are very beginner pictures that I did. And I am really, really looking forward to working in her book this year again for the Halloween season. This is what I did October 20th. So, you know, again, very beginner, but still kind of cute. That might be the only picture I did in this one. So I'm going to be working with markers in these books because I find it really hard to do pencils and the CreateSpace paper just for my hands. I did an entire picture yesterday with CreateSpace paper with all Crayola stuff, which I will be showing you, but it did hurt my hand by the end of the night. So I'm going to work with pencils and markers in this, but I'm really looking forward to getting back in this book now that the season is here. It's probably going to be one of the next ones that I pick up because I just love her books. I love her pictures, and I'm really excited to do some stuff in here. Okay, another one that I have for you is Witches and Whimsy, and this is in coloring book by Lauren Clare. Lauren sent this to me for review. I have started a picture in this. You may have seen a few flip throughs of this on YouTube already, but I have started one picture in this. I need to pick it back up, but again, it's CreateSpace paper, so it's a little harder for me to do. I did just start with my pencils on this one, and I will continue working on it, but I really like this one. This little girl is like dressed up as a witch, maybe going trick-or-treating. It's kind of very like ominous feeling to it, like she's out in the middle of the woods, like what is she doing? But I'm gonna try to make it my way with, you know, my pastel colors and stuff like that, and maybe not make it so ominous. But this is a really cute little book. You can get this on Amazon. It's got all different kinds of things in it, and I think it's nice to color, especially if you have some markers or single-sided. Like, look at this one. This is a great one for Halloween to do. You can make a really cute little cat there, and you could do all kinds of fun stuff with it. So I'm going to be looking forward to working in that for the Halloween season. All right, here's another one that I have. I bought specifically for the Halloween season this year. This is Halloween Coloring Book by Molly Harrison. Again, CreateSpace paper, so it's probably going to call for some markers. I wouldn't do watercolors in here. This page is the reason that I bought this book. I had to have it because this one is so super cute. So we'll see what I can do. I really like these books. Sorry, I'm getting off on a tangent here. I really like her little her little people books, whatever you call those, the littles. I really like those. So there's several pictures that I really like to do in here this year. And I have some fine liners. Like I said, I have some Sharpies and stuff. So I'll see what I can do with them. And whatever I get done, I get done. But this is a really cute book. And these books are really not that expensive. I think her books run about $7 to $9. And I think, I'm pretty sure that you can get her books on Etsy too if you just wanted to print them out. So there's that one. Here's another one along the same lines. This is Halloween Fairies 20 Image Coloring Book. I don't know who this is by. Oh, this is by Amy Brown. Yes, okay. So Amy Brown did this one. And this is just really cute. Again, little witch fairies with super cute Halloween pictures. I don't know how much I'll get to. We shall see. But really cute little pictures that I'd like to color and see what I can do with them. And of course, stickle them. How cute is that one? Really super cute. Look at this one. I love that one with the dragon. Adorable. I'm gonna have to just do that one. I have to. So there's that one. And the last one that I have for you is Autumn Scenes by Creative Haven. You guys know everybody's been getting this book and working in this book, and it is super cute, so I know why everyone's doing it. I did one picture from this so far. I did some of this on a stream, and it came out really cute. I'm very happy with it. I have no idea what I used on this. I want to say Polychromos, but we could go back to the video and look. I may have used Polychromos and those super colors because I was into those a lot while I was working in, like, during this time. But yeah, it's got some Wink of Stella on the flowers there, and I'm very happy with this book. I think it's really, 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 really nice, and it's got some Thanksgiving stuff in there. So this is another one that'll kind of carry me all the way through until I start working on the Christmas stuff. But the Halloween ones I really want to do in this book more so than the fall ones, just because they're really cute, and the whole book is really nice. So we'll see what I get done from that. So that is all of my autumn Halloween books that I would like to work in this season. We shall see. I've already started, as you can see, working on my fall Halloween stuff, and I will be doing more. So I would love to know if you have any of these books and if you're going to work in any of these books for the Halloween season. Are you going to be participating in our color along for the month of October? Like I told you with the Jasmine Beck Griffith book, if you can only work on one picture for the whole month that we are going to be working on it, please do that. Don't feel pressured to do every single picture. Pick one after we unveil which picture, who's going to be doing what, and work on it. You don't have to work on every single picture. You can just work along with us while we're coloring and chatting. So that's it, and that is what I'm looking forward to. And yeah, that's it for this video. So thank you for joining, and I will see you in my next video.